Hey guys, Ryno Bones here with an unboxing and building thing and a quick announcement. If you look down in the description below, you're going to see a link to a second channel. This is going to be my school channel where I like read books and do arts and crafts. And there's going to be some go between this channel and that one, but that one's the one that I share with the class, and this one's the private one that if they find it, they're lucky kids. But let's get to business. I've got the Small Six robot. I actually got two of these guys. One of them was on sale for $5 because it was an open box. I'm hoping when that one gets here, it's got all the pieces, but this one brand new cost a little under 20. It was $19.99. Let's open it up and take a look. First thing out of the box, we've got gears and cogs. We've got sunglasses, screws and little metal rods, tiny screws, big blue pieces. Feels pretty good. Big black pieces. Different type of plastic. Looks like we've got the body here. It's that harder blue plastic. We have its brain. We have a battery pack that holds 4 AAA batteries. Wires and motors. And a big chunk and instruction manual. As I did with my last one, I'm probably going to cut all the pieces out, get them all sorted. Then I will come back to you guys once I've got everything put together and give you a little review. Now that was an experience. This took almost 2 full hours straight from start to finish. And I kind of like the results. I had a few issues though. For one thing, the little sprue, the little extra bits of plastic that were stuck on the outside, I started trying to sand them down and stuff. And the usual thing I would do with some plastics is I just get a little torch and go over it and it would shine it right back up. Well, with this, check that out. I don't know if you can really tell there, it just almost immediately started melting, and I didn't expect that whatsoever. So the build process was pretty straightforward. There were something like 200 pieces. Not a lot, but just the way some of them go together didn't quite match my expectations. I had to do a lot of sanding, and it left some really nasty bits on here. So I think what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to get out some acrylic paints, maybe do a little bit of a wash, make this guy look all nasty and dirty, and yeah, post-apocalyptic robot, man. So now let's see if he actually works. I haven't turned it on yet, but I do have the directions right here. Looks like we press the key on the forehead for 2 seconds, which is another thing. That's actually one problem I did have, is the board that fits into the head didn't quite fit properly, so I had to use some super glue to hold it in place. You know, first world problems, what are you gonna do? Ready for this? Alright, so he's turned on. Both eyes glitter in standby mode, so he was in standby mode there. Oh, hello. What are we in now? Okay. Press the switch one time to enter mode 1. All right, we're in mode 1. Mode 1 is where it's called good friend mode. He's supposed to follow my hand. Whoa, hello. Oh my gosh, how cool is that? I'm gonna walk this little guy through here. Okay, so the sensor is right here. Oh, hello. And I think you have to be kind of down below so it'll actually work. So let me put my hand here on the table. Hey, where are you going, friend? Get over here. Weird. What is he doing? Let's go into mode 2. Adventure mode. Oh man, check that out. All right, so in adventure mode, he avoids obstacles. That's pretty cool. Wow, I am really impressed with this. This is so awesome. Go back that way, friend. too close to the edge. Very neat. All right, standby mode. Mode one, he's supposed to follow. Follow the front object if there is any. Step back if it's getting too close. So, follow my hand, friend. Back up if it gets too close. This is totally worth 20 bucks. It was fun to put together. It works exactly the way the instructions say it's gonna work. What an awesome deal. I cannot wait to get the second one. Man, because the second one I bought used Amazon open box policy there, and it was only $6, like $5.80-something. So, can't wait to have two of these little guys roaming around. This one, definitely gonna get an updated paint job. He is going to be the post-apocalyptic robot. Probably gonna take him apart and get some good paint on it. I'll come back and show that one sometime. These have kind of varying reviews. I went with the absolute cheapest one. There's some of them that are this exact same thing for 25 bucks, 27 bucks, 30 bucks. They're all exactly the same, just under a different company's name. I'll leave the link for the one that I've got here. And yeah, just know your results may vary, but if you've got a little bit of skill, these are pretty neat. All right, if you enjoyed watching the video, like, subscribe, all that stuff. Really check out my school site too. You might be interested in that if you've got some kids. It is going to be completely child-friendly, even though I think most of the stuff I upload already is pretty child-friendly, but it's gonna be geared directly for kids. And my first video is gonna be uploaded right about the same time I upload this one. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.